All right, I'm going to show you today how to use Google Earth for a math lesson. People don't usually think to use it for math, but I've done this lesson before and students really like it. So the first thing you're going to do is choose a location that the students are familiar with. And in this case, we're going to do our elementary school. Now it's going to zoom in pretty close. And in this case, I'm going to zoom in a little bit closer. Oh, got a pop-up saying where I am. Okay, so I'm in the right place. Now I can zoom in. Now what I like to do is I do a couple things. First, I like to use the playground. And what I would do with students, depending on their skill level, is you're going to choose a few questions for them to answer. And one of those questions may be, find as many circles on the school property as you can. Now that might be for somebody who's a little bit younger. If you're upper grades, you might do something with angles. How many right angles do you see on the playground? Or you could do something where you find a few things like add the hopscotches plus the four squares and divide it by how many basketball courts there are. Now, another thing you could also do, if we come over here, and I like to do this as well, parking lots are a lot of fun because you can look at all the cars and you can have the students come up with ratios. If they're doing fractions, it's fun to say maybe how many red cars are there. Make a fraction out of that. They would have to count them, count the total. You could also do cars to parking spaces. There's really a ton of different ways you could do this. The other thing that's really fun is to find famous locations and do the same thing. Like go to Disneyland and find how many people are in this certain area. Then students have to figure it out. There's also the option to search, like you could do from location, like maybe from the school to the student's home. You could say, how far is it from your school to your house, and then maybe multiply that by how far it is from your house to Disneyland or to the Statue of Liberty. And it's really fun, it's very engaging for the students, and it's good learning. I had a few students who picked up things that you never would have thought of, like we did from the school to their house, and then from the school to Disneyland. They were able to figure out that if they subtract the difference, that's how far it was from their house to Disneyland. And it was really fun because they were very excited about it. So anyway, this is a great way to use Google Earth if you're doing a lesson. It's a lot of fun. Please subscribe to our videos, and thanks.
Hey teacher, it's the Techno Rebel.
Oh. Oh.